Hello and welcome to the updated tutorial on how to get the VP9 codec on your YouTube video. This is the old video I did, the old tutorial, and this doesn't work anymore. The old method of getting the VP9 codec was to do something in the enhancement tab of your video. If you did that, then you would get the VP9 codec on your video, but that doesn't work anymore. The two other methods are either getting a lot of views and a lot of traffic, then you will get the VP9 codec automatically, or uploading in 1440p or 2K or higher. These are the only methods to get VP9. So you can check if you have the VP9 codec simply by right clicking on a video and clicking on Statistics for Nerds, and then you will see the codecs, and mine is actually VP9 on this video, but I have examples which there's not VP9. For example, this video doesn't have VP9, its codec is AVC. And that's an objectively worse codec. It doesn't matter on which quality setting you put it, it will be worse than VP9. So the simplest thing would be to just upload videos in 2K from now on. If you can do it, then do it. And if you can't, then this tutorial is for you. I will link timestamps in the description, and you can follow along the timestamps if you want to skip how I got to this conclusion and if you just want a tutorial. So what I did was, I had a 1080p video and I rendered it at different resolutions. The resolutions I chose were 1080p, 1440p, 1260p, 1200p, 1320p, and 1422p, and I rendered them. I compared the render times, the handbrake times, because I use handbrake to compress the videos, and then I measured the bitrate, the file size, and I uploaded them all to YouTube to see which one of them would get the VP9 codec. And the interesting thing is that I've waited all the time that I needed to upload and render the videos, and I put so much effort in creating this table that you can see right here, which is a weird mess of German and English and handwritten, which was completely worthless, because 1422p, which is almost 1440p, which is not many pixels off, got rounded down to 1080 and not rounded up. So unless you have 1440p, it doesn't count as 1440p and it won't get VP9. So this whole table is completely useless. We can just concentrate now on 1080p and 1440p. So if you wanna upscale your video from 1080p or 720p to 2K and then upload it to YouTube without having bigger files, which is important if your connection can't handle bigger files. My connection can't handle bigger files, that's why I did it. You have to render the video in your video editing software at exactly the same settings, the same bitrate and same quality settings, except the resolution has to be 2560 by 1440 pixels. Either that or more, but it can't go less. And to keep the same file size, you have to have the exact same settings. And a quick note, if you use handbrake like me, then you will have to upscale the video in your video editing software, because handbrake can't upscale videos. Handbrake can only downscale or keep them the same, so keep that in mind if you use handbrake. And to test if the quality would degrade, I tested this with my own workflow, which is rendering uncompressed in my editing software and then compressing in handbrake. So in handbrake, there are two methods of choosing what quality and bitrate your video will get: the constant quality setting and the average bitrate setting. And I used the constant quality setting. I tried two things. The first thing I tried was I kept the exact same settings for my 1080p video, but rendered my 2K video with this, and this produced a much larger file, and that's not what I wanted, because my connection can't handle bigger files. I need them the same size. I tested around with different quality settings until I got the closest to 1080p. While my 1080p preset was quality 19, the closest to that for 2K was quality 21. This produced almost the same bitrate and almost the same file size. It was slightly lower, so slightly worse quality, but it was by a tiny fraction, by like 2% or something, so it was negligible. And then I tested if the quality would change. So I tested if the 1080p video and the 2K video with the quality 19 and the 2K video with quality 21 would have the same or pretty close results on YouTube as well as locally, and you can see the tests now. As you can see, the 1080p video, this is the 1080p video, the original 1080p video doesn't have VP9 codec and it looks pretty bad. You can see in the lower right corner the arm, it's very undetailed, the foliage is undetailed, this is everything in here is, it's very undetailed, it's very, and the text is the worst. So let's see with the same settings, exactly the same settings, but 2K. You can clearly see the text. The text is just way better. It's so much better. And in lower right corner, it's actually worse. I don't know why. It's weird because some places are worse and some places are better. It's very weird. The foliage looks better in my opinion. And with worse settings, it looks better. I don't know why, but with worse settings, with lower bitrate, it actually looks better in my opinion. The lower right corner looks way better. The text looks the same. The foliage looks a bit more detailed, I feel like that's the case. It's a bit weird, but you can see the VP9 codec is clearly better. And to top that off, you have the 2K option. And if you compare these two now, this is just, there's just such a big difference. This is the 2K video with the same bitrate as this 1080p video, and there's just such a big difference. Just look at this wall texture. This wall texture suffers so much from 1080p. It's weird. It's so weird that this isn't 2K. This is not 2K, but it just looks way better than 1080p. It's 1080p upscaled, but it looks better anyway. So to conclude, if you want to have the VP9 codec and much higher quality and even 2K technically, even though your video is 1080p or 720p, I didn't try that with 720p. I didn't try that with 720p, but I can imagine it's the same. You just have to edit the video in 1080p normally, like you would do, and then render the video in your editing software at 2K. And if you use Handbrake, just keep in mind that Handbrake can't upscale, you have to do it in your editing software. And if you keep the same settings, the file size will be the same, the bitrate will be the same, but it will still have higher quality on YouTube. And I will do it from now on. So yeah, thanks for watching. If you haven't seen my old video, you can go and watch that. There was a big discussion on how we can still get VP9 on our videos, and I hope you all will only get VP9. I will put all this playlist and every or single one of these videos in the description so you can watch for yourself. And yeah, that's it. Bye guys.